got the twist grip connector here. We have the hand control connectors, and we're also doing our LED turn signals as well. Use a little pin tool, which I have here. It's just basically a long pin. And you use the pin connector tool to take off the connectors. It makes wiring a hell of a lot easier. The other important part is you're going to notice on the terminal ends, you can see they're stepped down a little bit. I'm going to use my stainless wire to wrap around the heads of these, so when I pull them through, I'm only biting the terminal ends, not pinching into the wires. So you're going to bunch these together, like so. These longer wires, we're going to just move out of the way. Take the stainless wire, wrap around the terminal heads, see that? You're going to pick up right under the terminal heads. Just like so. Pull that tight, wrap it around two or three times. Then we're going to twist them tight. Like so. Take this wire here, bend it down. Make sure your wire is nice and straight. We're gonna bend this in, like so. Crimp this together. Now, all you have is the wire that's going into the bar with this big head of terminal ends. Cut the excess wire off. These longer wires here, we're actually going to come up and loop around. This is actually going to make the wiring a lot easier when we pull it through, because you're going to have a nice rounded top, as opposed to just using all the terminal ends to grab all those edges on the inside. Going to use some electrical tape. Get a good look at that. Take the tape, wrap this around. Use the tape to make like a nice little point. And you're gonna tape down towards the bottom here. Still like to protect all the wires. Basically, just gonna wrap it right until I don't see any more wires, and then stop. Okay, we're gonna leave these here for a minute. I'm gonna take you to the other side. In front of this bar, you're gonna see, this is where both wires come out. I know the lighting in here sucks, and I'm really sorry. We're in the middle of Laconia Harley Davidson and Bike Week doing an install, so what better time to show you a video when you're under pressure? And all you guys are curious how we do it, and I get a lot of people that hit me up and say that it's impossible to run the wires through the bar, but this is a non-edit video, and I kind of wanted to show you exactly the steps that I do to make this easier. The two wires that come through the center, we're just going to cut right in the middle. Underneath my bar, I do have two hidden cheetah holes, which I don't know if you can see. I'm going to take this little hook. I'm going to come up in here, find that wire, and pull it through. Pull the wire down through this hole. It's gonna give me a nice straight shot pulling the wires through. So this on both sides, just get it ready for now. When you pull this through, try not to pull the wires through the top because it sucks pulling them back up. Okay, so now you see that I have the two wires that have run through my cheater holes. Loop. Lots of loop. You can get this at Home Depot. Basically gonna put some lube here. I'm gonna coat these, try not to get excited. Notice how I leave everything loose. This is so we can individually pull the wires through at the end when I come out that center hole. So yeah, it makes a mess. It sucks, gross, but the other important part is you want to keep these wires uniform the whole way through. So instead of just letting them get all bunched up, try to keep them so that they're going in line, in order, like they're not all kind of crisscrossing. And I like to run these so that basically I have the two wires on the bottom, one wire on top. And again, well, this is our setup with LED turn signals for our handguard lights. This is the stock Harley hand controls, and then we have our twist grip sensor. All right, here's the key right now. Basically, you want to take the stainless wire. You want to definitely come over here and get a better look at this. You want to wrap the wire around your hand. You want to push the wire in as you pull. Push, pull. Do not pull tight on these. You do not need to pull tight. It's all up here. I'm going to push just until I feel it catching this area here. Once I feel it's there, I'm going to push in hard and pull down at the same time. Past the bend now. Now I'm gonna pull to the bottom till I see the tape come out that little hole. So I'm pushing and pulling. Push and pull. Push and pull. There it is. Now I'm gonna take the wire, come back in that hole. Come out the center. Okay, now I'm gonna push and pull. Push and pull. Push and pull. And look at that. Okay, so now you'll see that my taped area is all exposed. All three of the wires are sitting out the end of the bar here. I'm gonna go ahead. I like to use a hook. Just come in and pull my wires out this area here. I have the throttle line, which I don't want. Let's see what we got here. We have our LED turn signal light. I'm gonna pull that through. Okay, now I'm going after the Harley hand control wire. There it is. Pulling that through. Throttle sensor. The wires will come through the slot slotted area. Now, I'm going to get this lube out of the way. And then I am going to untape this tape out of the way. Okay, now let's take a look at these wires here. You're gonna see what's going on. Again, I apologize for the lighting. You're gonna basically unwind these out. Hands are so damn slippery, sorry. And look at that. Now, I'm going to go ahead and show you how we pull these through and finalize this throttle side. Throttle side sucks. Throttle side is the hardest part to do because more wires are always on your throttle side. So I got the throttle here. I got my LED turn signals, and then I have the Harley hand controls. I'm going to go ahead and just focus on one at a time. Harley hand controls first. Done. LED turn signals. Push and pull, push and pull. Done. When you're running a PowerMad handguard turn signal kit, you want to run this wire leaving about 6 or 7 inches from the top of the bar down. This is the length that you do want to leave it, because when you go ahead and put it all together, you're going to want to run this through the control housings out and then fold it up and lock it into my handguard bracket. All right, now we're gonna focus on the throttle. We grab the throttle only, push and pull. Line that up. I machine these so that they're very nice and tight. They're not just gonna slip in and be sloppy. So you literally have to hold. I grab hold of the bar and push. And then that locks it in place. And there you have it. Unedited video showing you how we do our wiring. You can fine tune these just by pushing and pulling as well. The lube is awesome because the lube will stay in there and then eventually will dry up, and you don't have to worry about any, you know, chemicals or anything affecting the paint. That's our throttle side. We're good here. All right, here's this. You're recording, yeah?
Yeah.
Second half of this video. We're installing Harley Davidson heated grips and our PowerMad LED turn signals. So we got a lot going on this side as well. So we're gonna show you another video of how we like to do our wiring. Okay, we're gonna start by pulling out the stainless steel wire. I went ahead and took all the connectors off. As you can see here, proper tools, take these connectors off. You can, if you try to run the wires through the handlebars with the connectors, it is going to suck. It's not easy. It's too much going on with all the bends. Take the connectors off, save yourself a ton of time and a headache. So I went ahead and took the heated grip. This is the Harley hand controls, and then we're gonna grab our LED lights. LED lights, heated control, heated hand grip, and then the Harley hand control. Same thing that we showed you on the throttle side. You want to run the wire through the head of these terminal ends. So we're going to bunch these together. As you can see. And then I'm going to take my stainless steel wire and I'm going to pick up just underneath that terminal head. So you can see that. Wrap this around. Get two loops out of it. Then if you want to come over here and get a good visual of what's going on here, I got just the heads here. I'm going to take my pliers and twist this until I get it nice and tight. Not too tight. Yeah, don't want to break them. It's stainless steel wire, so it's, you know, it can...
You guys need anything?
Yeah, we're in the middle of Laconia Bike Week at the Harley Davidson dealership doing installs, and we got people around. Take a peek. How you guys doing today?
Good.
All right. And yeah, we're doing a video to show you guys what's up. So all right, cool. I just wrapped that around, twisted it a little bit. Notice how I have this wire running down. This is the wire that's going in the bar. I'm just gonna go ahead and cut a little excess off. I'm gonna crimp this down just a little bit to kinda, I don't want any sharp objects sticking out of this as I pull it through, so. Okay, now we go ahead and make sure this wire is nice and straight. So you got it all happening here now. We got all these wires. There's a lot going on. All right, so I got some tape here. We're gonna go ahead and wrap these up. Wrap tape around, make a nice little point. When we do the Harley heated grips, I only like to run the tape just down about a little over 2 inches. Because we're going to need access to this at the bottom. The good thing is with my 12 and a half inch POV twisted T-bar, you do not have to extend the Harley heated grip when you're fishing the wires through. The wire is organized, like I said in the other video there. So I'm gonna coat all these guys. Keeping all four wires separate. Cool little trick too is, if you want to make things easier, put a little like roundness on the head of this wire harness I just set up here. It'll make it nice and easy when it comes down, goes into that first turn there. All right, so we're ready. I'm gonna go ahead and grab our stainless steel wire. Trying to keep these wires nice and organized without them going all over the place. But I'm coming up on that first turn, so I'm gonna push and pull. And we're past it. Coming down towards the bottom. you see the tape, there it is. I'm going to take the stainless wire, come back in through my hole, come out the front here. You see that coming through? I'm going to pull that through. And then we're going to continue pushing up here just till we make that bend. Now, since we don't have much more area to pull up here, I'm going to pull my turn signal wires and my hand control wires through. Gotta find which one is which. Alright. And the hook that I'm using, I actually went ahead and took the sharp point out of it because we don't want to pinch any wires. So it's kind of like a dull point, which is nice because you don't want to cause any damage to your wires. I'm pulling through the turn signal wire for our LED handguards. That is that there, and then we're gonna grab the Harley hand control. There it is. All right. Now we have those two through. Have a rag nearby because the lube is kind of gets a little aggressive. So we're gonna push on our wires here through the slot, and then we're gonna push on the key to grip. You can see that they're trying to find their way out. So just gonna do a little at a time here. I know it's slippery. Push in a little more, and look at that, pull out the bottom. There they are. I'm gonna go ahead and untape these. Remove this wire. So look at that, we have all four of these wires coming out the bottom of the bar. Now your heated hand grip, this is about the just about the length that you're gonna have, which is fine because all the wires are right here. We're gonna focus on the LED turn signal wire first, which I'm just gonna push and carefully pull out the bottom. Look at that, done. Like I said in the other video, when you're running our LED turn signal kit, you wanna leave about 6 inches of wire exposed. Leave it at this length, don't go any further, because we're gonna go ahead and tie these in up afterwards. I'm gonna take the Harley hand control wires, push on the top, pull them through. Leave a couple inches so we can put the controls on. Heat of grip is all the way in, that's bottomed out. There it is, everybody. So we just wired a set of our bars with heated grips and LED turn signals. This is about as complicated as it's gonna get.
it's a lot easier when you do not run heated grips, and it is easier when you don't run the LED turn signal. So you can see how fast we just did this by myself here in Laconia Harley. You guys can absolutely handle this on your own with just a little bit of patience and a lot of lube.